How are we doing, guys? Chucky Boy here again, and as you've just seen in the beginning of this video, we have a brand new intro for this series. Now, I haven't done a great deal since the last time you guys have been here. I will quite easily show you what I have done. I think I've put it in here, keep it safe. Here we go. I have managed to find 5 pieces of copper. That is all I have done. I didn't want you guys to miss too much. I'm even going to show you exactly where I found it, because there's still some left to go pick up. But I had to go back home and make a new pick, because my pick ran out while I was mining this. I've gone home, made a new pick, and we're going to go back and we're going to go fetch the rest. I think there may be 3 or 4 pieces left, but we need it. So, yeah, I'm going to go fetch that before I forget. It's not actually too far away. It took me a while to find because I was looking in the big ravine that we have near our home, our base. I was looking all over the place in there, and I went down back down into the little mining pit that I did in a previous episode too, and couldn't find any there. So I was just basically walking around for a little while and stumbled upon another ravine, basically. Kind of forgot where it is now though. It's this way, I believe. Yeah, I kind of forgot where it is. I think it's over here. And you'll see exactly where I've been going, because obviously I've got, you know, access. Look, this is basically what I came across. I came over here, over the hill, from the house, and it was like, oh my god, this is amazing. So, I think if we go down here, I'll take you as close as I possibly can without dying, just so you can see what's down here. This is not connected to the previous one, but there's a lot of stuff in here that I've not even looked at yet. It's just somewhere else we can explore at a later date. But somewhere around here we go, is you'll see where I started digging. Now, I found the ravine, obviously, but there was nowhere for me to go safely. You know, I could have gone down here, but I didn't have much life at the time, so I was quite worried about food. So I basically just guessed and dug a hole and dug some stairs down. So I managed to find it. It's pretty simple, to be honest. And yeah, basically, as you can see here, I'm now at the copper. There's only 3 pieces left, I think. But we couldn't pick those up before. Oh, look, there's iron underneath. We'll pick that up while we're here. Might as well. There's a rat. Oh, wow, okay. Maybe that was a bit silly. I don't know if it's safe to dig. I should never dig below me, but I always do. That's a zombie. Oh, what's that? Tin. Oh, cool, we need tin. Didn't know this was here. There's a zombie somewhere. Right above me. Ow, I'm on fire. I'm on fire. Thank you, zombie. We need tin because we need to make some more, just in case we need to make some more machines. I have actually got a plan that I thought about since the last time. Do you know what? I'm going to dig back up, actually, and just get back home before I lose what I've already got. Might have to make some more stairs there. Okay. Yeah, I've basically got a new plan. I've kind of been obviously aiming towards getting a macerator, which is why I need the copper to make some cables and so on and so forth. But I kind of forgot about a machine that is pretty useful too, which I'm going to actually go do now. And I'll show you guys what that is in a minute. Let me just get home and get safe first, because, you know, I do have a habit of pausing this game at the wrong time, talking for a little while, and then end up dying and losing everything that I've just worked for. So let's just quickly run home and we shall run through exactly what the plans are for this little session that we're recording right now. But we're starting to get our bearings a little bit. We've got a good few places to explore. You know, we've got we've got 2 ravines pretty much close to our home, you know, that we can go explore and hopefully find some good stuff in there. But the project I'm going for right now is, if we go back into our system here and we, I can't remember what it's called, so we'll just type table. Oh, okay, I can't even type. Type table. It's not a crafting table, it's like a, it's a work table. There we go. I think that's it. Yeah, it is a work table. And just make sure. How do we make a work table? We need a book, a chest, and a crafting table. Okay. I can't remember how to make a book. Leather and 3 pieces of paper. So paper is obviously made from reeds, which we don't have. But we've got leather somewhere. There we have leather there. Do we have any wood? Yes, I can make a crafting table. Ah, I just throw my wood away. Okay. Crafting table. Let's make that first. Or a chest, should I say. Sorry, I meant to say chest. Chest, crafting table, and we need a book. So we need to go find some reeds. Okay. We got some time. I'm not quite sure where to go for reeds. Do we... We need water, obviously, for reeds. I'm hoping there's some about somewhere over here. Can't see any. I think there was some in the forest, wasn't there? Near the pools of water. I don't know. We'll find. Whoa. Okay. I need to pay attention to where I'm going. We'll find some reeds somewhere. Hopefully not too far away. Are there reeds here? Ow. Maybe I shouldn't have done that. No reeds there. Okay, where to go now? More water over here. No reeds? Nope. Okay, let's try over this way. I can't really remember where water is, to be honest. There's a few little bits, but there's nothing major. That looks interesting. Maybe we get a little bit sidetracked right here. This is the kind of thing that I do. I get sidetracked quite easily and then end up regretting it. But we've got a lot of stuff in here. Obviously, there's also the dangers of things creeping up. We don't need appetite, or I don't think. Yeah. Let's go the other direction and see what's further down. I don't think we need that for anything yet. Not quite sure. That would be a skeleton or a zombie on fire over there. Zombie, come on, into the sunshine, Mr. Zombie. There we go. Okay, you're dead. Okay, so there's only iron down there. We don't really need that right now. I see no reeds. Okay, let's go back. Not really sure where to look. I don't want him to change to a werewolf while I'm stood near him. Because those things are ridiculously powerful. Where's the sun? The sun is going down soon, so maybe we should head home. And we'll get a book sorted out one day. Well, we can start obviously making our crafting table. We'll make our macerator and stuff like that. We'll get the cables ready for that, so gives us something to do. And then we'll sleep, and then we'll go back on the reed hunt, you know, in the morning when it's safe. Need to get home. I'm going to have to sprint, I think. I know you guys are probably watching this thinking, why do you sprint everywhere, but I just prefer it. I just think it's quicker. I know it wastes food and stuff like that, and health and stuff, but, you know, I just prefer to sprint. I think it's faster. Plus, I am a little girl and I get scared quite easily, so. Okay. So what we're going to do is we're going to actually take our copper that we've collected. Now we've got 8 pieces of copper. We'll put that in the furnace over here. We can put copper in there. We can put some coal in there. Let's split the coal up. And we'll get the tin going. And we'll put the rest of the coal in there. And we'll get the iron going. Just so we can build up a little collection of stuff. Let's put those in the chest for safekeeping. What is in here that we need? We need copper. And we need rubber. And we need cables. I believe we need refined iron as well. Let's go back and check. Macerator. We need flint too. I forgot about flint. Machine block is refined iron in a block, which is easy enough to do. Electronic circuit is what we need to do right now. Okay, so what we're going to do first is we're going to build these individual things. We have flint, I believe. Where is it? Flint. Where are you? There you go. We've only got 2 pieces. Okay, we have gravel. That's fine. We can get ourselves another piece of flint. That's not a problem. We have cobblestone. What else do we need? Machine block is 8 pieces of refined iron, which I don't know if we have. I think we've got 6, but we can put 2 more in the furnace. Let's take the copper out of the furnace. Let's take some of you and put 2 of you in there. Okay. So then, we're going to have our 8 pieces of refined iron, so we can... There's a zombie at the door. Go away, zombie. Thank you. Right. So we're going to make a machine block. We're going to... Oh, more zombies. Go away, zombie. Right. Try again. We keep getting rudely interrupted, but we'll keep going. Let's try and get another piece of flint. Now, the way I like to get flint is by putting it, believe it or not, in a macerator or a pulverizer. You'll get a piece of flint from gravel. But we don't have those machines right now. So what we're going to do is we're going to do it the old-fashioned way. We are going to place down some gravel. I didn't mean to place those there like that. But we're going to place these gravel blocks down. And what we're going to do is we're going to quite simply just dig them until we get flint. It's boring, I know, but, you know, this is the only way I really think we can do it. Unless I can go outside and find some, you know, a really big sort of gravel sort of area, but I don't think there is any. So we're just going to do it this way and hopefully we'll get one soon. Won't have to wait too long. I think we got one there, to be honest. Yep, we did. So it didn't take too long, did it? Okay, so we got our refined iron. We'll go back to the crafting table and we'll make our machine block. There we go. So we have you there. We have two pieces of cobblestone. What else was it? I can't remember. Three pieces of flint. And it was the electronic circuit, I believe. Yeah. So the circuit is refined iron. So we need another piece of refined iron. Okay, fair enough. We'll go put some in here. I'll put all of those in, to be honest. I've got some more to smelt at some point. Let's go put the tin in the chest out of the way. We don't lose it. Right. We need redstone. I don't know if we have redstone. That's not a good noise. That's a zombie horse. Okay, that worried me. There's a spider in the top of my house. Thinking a zombie horse might be up there too, to be honest. Where was I? Circuit. Cables, redstone, and refined iron. Okay, so we need to make cables now, don't we? Just need one more, but you get six, you know, from each one. So we go here, and copper in the middle. There we go. Right. And so now we've got those. We have two pieces of you. Or is it just one piece? I can't remember now. It's one piece, I think. Refined iron. Let's go get you. Seven pieces will do nicely. Right, okay. Let's see if we can remember what to do. No, it was two pieces of redstone, wasn't it? One, two. You and you. And hopefully you. There we go. Right, so now we can build our macerator. Try and do it from memory. No, what goes there? And a machine block in the middle. Hey, we have a macerator. Awesome. Okay, so what we're going to do with this, guys, is we're going to put this next to... We're going to place this right next to... Do you know what I'm going to do, actually, is... Just listen to the noise. It's crazy. There's no point sleeping. It's getting daylight, so... Hopefully they burn pretty soon and we can carry on with this. Right, okay, what we're going to do is we're going to go with the macerator here. See, the macerator is automatically turned on the generator. So it's being powered, which is then using power out of here. What I'm going to show you, hopefully, I don't think I should have left some iron or something so I could show you exactly what... There we go, we've got iron here. So what happens here is... you put things in the macerator, like any ore, like copper, tin, you know, iron, all that other good stuff. You put it in there, and it macerates it. You can hear it going. You've got a little progress bar here, and what you get out of one block, you'll get two pieces of dust, basically. Hopefully. There we go. So we've got two lots of iron dust. So we'll just take those two for now, and I'll show you what to do with those. You go over to the furnace, and basically, if you put the two pieces of iron dust in there, you'll get two iron ingots. So from one iron ore block, we end up with two iron ingots, so it basically doubles your output every time. And, you know, obviously with building, a lot of things requires, you know, a hell of a lot of tin and copper and stuff like that for cables and all that other good stuff. Then, you know, it's a necessary step to take to get this machine working, you know, quite well. Now you can actually feed this directly into another kind of furnace, which will be a project for another day. There's a different kinds of furnaces too, but we're going to look at an electric furnace because we have the power now. So there's an induction furnace which I think works from, is it lava, I believe? I'm not quite sure how they work, to be honest. I could be completely wrong, but we're going to go with electric furnace because it's pretty simple to make. All you do is you make an iron furnace, which is basically a normal furnace with, you know, it's just an iron block, effectively. And we're going to go with that because after that we can already make one of these circuits. They're pretty simple. Like I said, you've already made a few already. And basically the electric furnace is the same as a normal furnace, but it just works quicker. And you don't have to actually power it by coal. It works obviously off electric. So do we actually have stuff to build that with right now?